All Talk Radio / 2RAW4TV, man.
If you hear my voice, then you're part of the revolution. Welcome to the new world. This is your host, the Ratchet Revolutionary Palmetto Star. Hey, hit me up on Twitter at Palmetto_Star. I'm also on MelanatedPeople.net, Palmetto Star. Hit me up. Interracial relationships are mind control. Yes, it need to be said. Interracial relationships have always been about mind manipulation and Caucasian control. During slavery, plantation owners would have relationships with their women slaves, impregnate them, only to use their own babies for alligator hunting. Today, many pink females have adopted the racist moniker of Queen of Spades, just like their demented, devilish forefathers. They seduce sleeping, unconscious black brutes to do their bidding. After they use them for sexual pleasure, clout, and mixed children, some of this lot allege rape of their ex-beaus and teach their now black children the ways of white supremacy. They say love has no color. But when 98% of black people still work for the same people who enslaved their ancestors, are interracial relationships colorblind or confused? We're going to talk about that, plus so much more. We're going to go in. This is going to be a revolutionary month for 2RAW4TV, so you don't want to miss a word. But what you want to do is call 516-453-9174. The phone lines are filling up extremely quickly. I've got a lot of crazy comments. A lot of people got mad over this, blocked me, reported photos, all of that, because this is something that needs to be said a lot, and nobody else is saying it but 2RAW4TV. And we're going to tell you exactly why it's happened and why it's so important right now for you to know this information. So call in 516-453-9174. We're going in all night tonight, and I am going to get to all the callers, so make sure that you press 1 so I know that you have a comment or question. I know a lot of people have been hitting me up and saying they want to say this, they want to say that. I don't know that you want to say anything unless you press 1, because that's my indicator. A lot of people call in to listen, so I know I want them to listen. But if you got something to say, if you have a swirling story, and we're going to go into that, swirlers and all of that, so we're going to go in. If you have one of those stories, call in, tell us about it. But, you know, first I got my nigga from Nigeria, Ernest Paul. You know, he does top song of the week for Africa or from Europe, and he does it on a segment called The Heat that you can hear exclusively on 2RAW4TV. So we're going in on that. This would be a perfect time to get on Snapchat, to get on Facebook, to get on Instagram. Let them know that the revolution will not be televised. It's 2RAW4TV. We're going in tonight. What is your swirling story? So a lot of people don't know what swirlers are. We're going to talk about that, plus so much more. But you're only going to be able to hear it right here on 2RAW4TV. Is love colorblind? Heat with Ernest Paul. It's 2RAW.
This is the Heat with Ernest Paul on 2RAW4TV, bringing you top songs of the week in Africa, also in Europe. Yes, I'd like to use this opportunity to welcome you all to another fantastic week. Yeah, this week promises to be so exciting, and we're just getting started. But first of all, before I kick off this segment known as the Heat with Ernest Paul on 2RAW4TV, I will just have to talk about the gist that is on everybody's lips right about now. Now, this has made me to want to speak about a rapper that was killed in Florida, right at Deerfield Beach, according to some statements that were at Florida over there in U.S., and it was quite sad, actually. And this particular rapper never got the chance to fulfill his purpose on Earth. I had seen a whole lot of criticism directed at him from so many people, and I'm not going to speak about that. But one thing I'm going to talk about was that he did something that he never knew that he did before he passed away. It is so, so sad, but that is just the actual truth right about now. I think earlier today, I was coming from a wake keep that I attended. Yes, one of our members in our church passed away, aged 71, and she was a woman, and her name was Iyabo Shadari. So it was quite sad. I attended it. But the most beautiful thing about it was that she was around the people that loved her from the beginning, meaning her children down to her grandchildren. So it was wonderful. People were just joyous. And a lot of people said it was a life that was well celebrated. So we celebrated our demise. That is our death. We celebrated it in a wonderful way because she got to a certain age where I would say her age at that particular moment was a fulfilled one on earth. She had so many people around her, especially her children and her grandchildren were present to grace up the occasion. So quickly, let me just move on to what I need to say. Now, this has made me to want to talk about what is on everybody's lips. I believe that in Nigeria, I'm speaking for the upcoming artists because I'm a beat maker. Apart from that, I'm a rapper, I'm a singer-songwriter, and apart from that, I'm a correspondent working for 2RAW4TV. I'm a beat maker, a music producer, and it is quite actually difficult for artists in Nigeria to like raise money to want to go into the studio and do a song. And there's another particular thing entirely for the song to get mixed and well mastered. Now, this particular artist that is no more discovered something, and it is now his footprint, and it has become his trademark even after when he had gone. He didn't know this, but he has actually touched a whole lot of people's life right about now. Now, let me just quickly say this. There was a mistake that occurred, especially when he was pushing out some of his track here, and he did not mix and master that track properly. He didn't do any one of that at all. And that track got to so many places, and people still felt that song. And he came out to say that it is high time that they should be doing song like this. He just said it knowingly before he passed away. He never knew that this would be the major discovery that would ever happen to hip-hop or to music generally. So I am saying this generally, that artists out there, look, for you to get your song to be considered in Nigeria, yeah, you must have spent some kind of fortune. Yes, let me just say, you go to the studio to go and do a song in Nigeria, yeah, I think you should be spending close to like more than $100. It should be going to like $300 or $200 for an upcoming artist. That is a good studio right now. Then apart from that, the money that you are going to pay when it comes to mixing and mastering for you to get a quality, well-mixed and mastered song, you are going to be spending close to like $300. Now, tell me, how many artists can be able to afford that, can even be able to afford money to do a track? How much more mixing and mastering that particular track? It is killing upcoming artists. That is why we have a whole lot of artists coming out in Nigeria, and they are doing some kind of songs that you would listen and you would be like, are these songs really coming out from Nigeria? So that is just it. That is why we are not truly discovering talented ones in Nigeria. So most of all these songs that you're hearing coming out from Nigeria, honestly speaking, they are not from artists that were made to sing, that were made to do this. They weren't from them. They are not truly the talented ones. You have not really heard talented artists in Nigeria. I am really telling you. So I've been around upcoming artists, spoken to them, and I was able to get some few things from them too. And I just have to say this, they had flows, most of them that I spoke to, and I talked about some kind of things to them, and they gave me some kind of life experience and know that they are well talented. Just like this young dude, XXXTentacion, he's no more right now, but I'm saying rest in peace to him. What a great discovery. He discovered that, and I'm telling upcoming artists out there, even in USA right now, you're listening to my sweet voice. Yes, never mind if my voice is so sweet. Go to the studio, do a track. Don't be carried away by what people would hear, especially when they'll be listening to your song. Don't get carried away by that. Just go to the studio, do a track, and mix it the way you want to mix it. Don't go out there trying to meet up with some kind of standards that are out there. Just do your thing and leave the rest. If they don't like it, they don't like it. It doesn't mean that you are going to drop what you are doing. Just keep on doing it. So I just want to say big shout out to XXXTentacion is no more. That was a great discovery. This discovery, I'm going to take it to my grave. So upcoming artists out there, go to the studio, do a song. Don't get bothered about the quality of the song. Just write a good verse and a good beat, and that's so you have a hit on your hands. So let me quickly move on to where I just got to provide you the top song of the week in Africa or in Europe. Yes, I think I am done with the whole XXXTentacion. I don't want to quickly move to the murder case because it was an homicide by firearm that resulted to his killing. I saw some photos, some images prompting up here and there, popping up, and I'm seeing some faces, and I heard that he got killed by a black guy too. So I just don't want to go into that, and I'm not really sure that that news is actually concrete. So these are just some suspected murders, and I don't want to say this, I don't want to say that. I love being concrete, you know what I mean, especially when it has to do with the hit with tennis for on 2RAW4TV. 2RAW4TV is where you get the most concrete news ever, where the
All right, that was Ernest Paul. He's bringing the heat this week from Africa. He just dropped, but I'm going to let him come back in if he calls in. But you guys call in right now, 516-453-9174. We have to talk about some stuff. Interracial relationships are mind control. If you have a comment or question, press 1. We're going in on that tonight. Got swirlers talking about everything. But let me do this. I'm going to play this song. This is the top song from Africa, from Ernest Paul. And we'll hear a little bit more from him if he calls back in. But you guys call in right now, 516-453-9174. We're going in on this, talking about a lot of different things. Interracial relationships are mind controls. 2RAW4TV. Oh, hit up Ernest Paul on Twitter right now, I_MEP. He's a great producer, great singer, and he gets those beats, so hit him up. This is The Heat with Ernest Paul.
Assurance, yeah, assurance, yeah. I give my baby
Interracial relationships are mind control. On YouTube, someone called that a brazen statement. Why is this true? And what is the evidence that supports it? When I talk about interracial relationships, I'm talking about the context of what people describe as Anglo-American, Anglo-Saxon, and black people. That's what I'm talking about tonight, and we're going to go into different sorts of interracial relationships. But in this country, the history of black people relationships with white men, pink men, white women has not been one that has been peaceful or loving. In early America, white slave owners would rape their black women that they had held captive and termed slave. And many of them would have faux relationships with these people, treat them better, give them better space, make them feel wanted. And black people always are pushing love from a pure place for the most part. And in these relationships, the woman would get pregnant, they would have a baby, and that baby would be taken away. Now, this baby is also the slave owner's baby. And he would take that child, that infant child, that black baby, and use it for bait and alligator hunting. This was such an American tradition that they made postcards about it, songs, and several memorabilia about this trend happening in slave-ridden America. And it's still happening to this day in different forms. So when you talk about someone that has done that to you for hundreds and hundreds of years, and we're going to talk about the black men too, but when you talk about these relationships that have been going on for hundreds and hundreds of years like that, and then they tell you you're free but give you the context of freedom according to their reality, How can you say that you even ever can have an interracial relationship? Because you're working for the same people that enslaved you and did this. You're working for those same people. 99% of blacks were the labor force in America during slavery. In 2018, it's 98%. You can't have a relationship with this being. It is not, there's no dynamic for a relationship. There's always going to be a subconscious, if not conscious, show of privilege, show of power. It's like going on a date with your boss or having a relationship with your supervisor, even though you know you could say that this is not job related, we don't talk about work and all that stuff. There's always that dynamic that this person has some sort of dictation on my life. They could fire me, they could do whatever. So it has always been a form of mind control. It has always been a form of business. Further use black people. But what do you guys think? Call in 516-453-9174. Interracial relationships are mind control. I do want to get to all the callers on the line. Make sure to press 1 if you have a comment or a question. 253, you're on the line with 2RAW4TV. Interracial relationships are mind control. Now, I just named an example of mind control under the guise of interracial relationships in America. What is your thoughts on interracial relationships and mind control? You're on the line. Hello. You may want to take it off mute. You may want to take it off mute. I hear you now.
Yep. Oh, okay, I was trying to fix it. Okay.
Okay.
Now, what was the question again? I'm sorry, I was taking notes as you were talking.
Well, I was more or less posing the statement, but the question is, how can we even have interracial relationships when relationships with someone of a pink tone has been historically been about power, been about business, been about mind manipulation and subjugation? How can we now in 2018 with these people that have practiced these business practices, have had handed down these family secrets, and not taken to the account that there's still the dynamic of owner and slave? How can we have a relationship with that person? That's more or less the question.
Okay, I'm going to answer that.
All right.
I have never really dated outside of my race like that. I never dated outside of my race, but coming from a family with a lot of that in there, I would say that speaking from observance, I wouldn't deny that there is those problems that exist as far as the racism or whatever you want to call it, about the whatever, economic, money, whatever. But in the reality, I mean, we can look at this in so many levels where it could be bad, but it also, at the same time, is going to start being beneficial, because if there is no, I would say, African-American men left or African-American women, and I'm not making this as an excuse, I'm just saying, in general, people don't like to be lonely, and we're living in a time where, you know, people are just dying lonely, and some will probably die to their death or whatever, but I think that they will figure out a way to work things out, a couple, no matter what culture, race that you are. Because being that, like I said, I have biracial niece and nephews, and they pretty much, the way I look at it, my brother was actually given a company. The company was given to him by this white man who is the father of this white girl. He actually literally put the company in his name. Now, I know this may be one situation out of many, but he ain't going to be here too much longer, that white man, because he's old now. And now my brother will own that business. And, yeah, he's the father of those children. And I have never honestly ever seen them argue or fight or none of that. He just happened to pick somebody that, you know, as far as I can see, have seen in, over the few years that, you know, get along real well. So with that being said...
Well,
also,
well,
let me say this.
I want to interject something just real quickly. No, I definitely hear you. And now, this is something that a lot of people say, you know what I'm saying, to give defense of interracial relationships. They do point out good deeds that white people have done, pink people have done for blacks. But at the same time, they're afforded those things. You think it's major, but these people are making like $45,000 more than the average black family. This is your money, too. I mean, not to mention the fact that if there was no racism or bigotry, they wouldn't even be here. They wouldn't even be here. So they have $45,000. They're, you know, extra, the average. That's just the average fake bum on the street, pink person. $45,000 in his pocket, more than the average black person, black family.
Okay.
I mean, there's a lot of good deeds that are, that they do, but I mean, it's all mind manipulation, because the slave owners did good deeds for slaves too. The KKK gave black people gifts on Christmas.
Yeah,
so, I mean, it's like...
I think that's just the white supremacy of the system, period. But we gotta... all of us are not going to agree. But some of us that deal with white people and some of us that don't deal with them at all, that completely live their lives separated from them... gotta know by now that, I mean, come on, if everyone, we can't blame the entire system on dating interracially. Let's just be real about that, because that has really nothing to do with those two people consenting adults. That's just like me saying.
On the interpersonal level, it may not. But at the same time, there's this history of it.
Right.
What's
but
that?
I'm just saying we're going to always have the history of the ugly, the evil that is still.
But that's not even our history. That is just like a blip in time. If you talk about black people in this country that have been in this country. Enslavement, I mean, chattel slavery and all this stuff, it's only been a short period of time. Kush had thousands and thousands, the empire of Kush was thousands and thousands of years old and had peace for thousands and thousands of years. America's only been around for not even 300. So we have to understand. We have to understand what's happening right now. And no, maybe not on the interpersonal level is does that affect them? Like I was saying, there's a lot of time, but it's all contrite. It's all created, and it's just like illusionary. These people still have pink privilege. They're not going to give up their pink privilege, and they will use racism against their partner. You know, so it's not really a relationship dynamic. You're still dealing with white Jesus in your house. You know, Billy comes in and he's just off of work. You're looking at him like white Jesus. No black person in America has completely erased that construct, white Jesus, from their memory banks. It's still there. There's still a tinge of it there. You know what I'm saying? And whether you're a Christian, whatever, it doesn't even matter, because that image of white Jesus was used on a demonic fashion, and all black people look at white people in a way like that, and there's still a hint of that here. There's still a hint of it, not on this line, not none of y'all, but there's still a hint of it. So,
okay, well, let me say this. I'm not going to play devil's advocate. I'm not going to flip it, but we got to be honest with each other. Whether we say that or not, black men were raped. We know that. And black women were raped back in, 300, 400 years ago. We know that. Ain't no denying that. But we know what came from that, right? Mixed people. So we're not going there yet, but I'm saying we live in a time now where it's more interracial mixing coming from the African American black communities than any other race.
No.
Yeah. I'm talking about with black and white, because if that was not true, there would not be the majority of whites still being supreme.
That is what you're saying is not a true story, or not real. It is not real. It is recorded. It is recorded by the census, but it is not a true statement. When you have North Africans, and you have Arabs, when you have certain Latinos that can check mark white without any second glance. Black North Africans, as dark as me, check out my profile picture on Palmetto_Star at Twitter. But these are North Africans.
Right,
and they're check marking white for they're check marking white on the census. So
they was never taught their real history until maybe the last few years. And I know you're that's true. That's very true what you're talking about. I know you know them, and I know them. In fact, some of them used to live with me that were from the islands of down there, you know, in Puerto Rico and Cuba. They have lived with my father in the East Coast did not know they were actually black, and they were, you know, very deeply melanated, or whatever you want to call it.
Let me say this. I wanna say this, because I gotta go to another caller. Hey, where are you calling from, by the way? I noticed this is
Kent, Washington.
Yes. Where are you calling from?
Kent, Washington.
Where?
Washington State.
Okay. I wanna get more into this, but let me just say this. they fabricated their numbers. You know what I'm saying? To make it look like there's more of them. What you're calling mixed children, I call black. I'm sorry, is black. I don't care if you had if your great-great-great-grandfather was black, you were black. You know what I'm saying?
We're gonna be
inclusive. We need to broaden black is, because there's like all these different things. How white, quote unquote, white supremacy is successful is because they subcategorize us, they compartmentalize us, they take us away from each other with all these insane labels, you know, and then you got children living in this biracial bubble, then and saying all color, you know, love has no color, and you know, and they're looking at atrocities of Mike Brown, you know, all Trayvon Martin, Tamir Rice, people that are getting gunned down on the streets, and they have no, they are put in this biracial bubble of bullshit that sort of separates them from the black experience. They try to, but most of these people do claim black, and we gotta no, there's no mix. There's no mix. You're black. Now these were black children that, you know, so, you know, all that mixed stuff. You know, I definitely feel that you know, we definitely need to have the leadership of black nations be as dark as possible, so even the most lightest skin black person can you know, see that image at the same time.
But it's the black community. That's what I was saying. The black community is the ones, and I know this to be fact because I'm always in these groups going at it with the same topic. They're the ones that be redefining mixed people. I'm saying black.
Yeah,
people.
I know.
Telling them
black people are most black people are asleep, are straight sleeping.
They'll say you're not black.
Right.
If you got one parent of one race, one of the other, you are not black. And then when they say that they're mixed, they'll turn around and say, you're not mixed. You're black. You want to be the other side. And then we got to stop generalizing on every household, because every household.
Well, let me do this, because I had to get to the next caller, sister. We got some more minutes in the live stream. I want you guys to call in right now. 516-453-9174. We're going in on this subject. Interracial relationships are mind control. 901, you're on the line with 2RAW4TV. What's your
thoughts? How you doing? This is Tony. I'm from Memphis. I'd like to shout out to Anubi because she put me on to your show. I also like to shout out to Whitney. I love you, baby.
Right.
I'd like to say, first of all, a person's capacity to love someone else can never exceed their capacity to love themselves. And if you don't know who the fuck you are, you have no idea how to love yourself. So how in the fuck does that qualify you to love a white woman? Now, to get into the historical ramifications of everything, how do you get past the countless numbers of times that one white woman calls 10 black guys be swinging in a goddamn tree? And all of this financial benefits from dealing with these bitches, if they can requisition their money from Tiger Woods and Bill Cosby, surely they can get back whatever crumbs and pennies they give to you. And you get no credit for giving me $10 after you stole $10 million from me. I don't buy that bullshit at all. And you wipe out all the black Wall Streets, all of the black financial structures, all of the black educational structures, and you hand me a crumb, and I'm supposed to give you credit for that bullshit? Second of all, I mean, next, you know, silence is consent. There's outrage about this bullshit at the border. What about these weak-ass kids that are the product? Because if the white race is weaker than the black race, then a mixed child is weaker than a black child. What about these kids? When are we going to cry for our own, what we produce from a black couple, a black union? Why does everybody else get the glory and we're always left on the shelf? 2 million kids incarcerated, separated from their families, and we're crying about 2,000 motherfuckers on the border. I mean, come on now. It's time for us to wait. How much disrespect can we take? How much bullshit can we swallow and still smile? Why are we the only race that can take it up the ass and still love our fucking masters like we some goddamn retards? I don't understand.
Let me say this. No, I absolutely love what you're saying, brother. And I want to go into it a lot more, so I want you to hold on the line. 516-453-9174. Remember to press 1 if you want to speak. I am taking all callers, so press 1 if you have a comment or a question. Go ahead, press 1 now, too, if you hear my voice. But press 1 if you have a comment or question. we're going to go in on that subject. Now, I want to get into all of that, and what you're saying is absolutely correct. Most black people can't even think outside of their bills, their current day-to-day situation, and the sort, not disregarding how they feel, but it only matters what the most conscious of us black people feel, because it only matters what you feel, because we have to elect to be the mind of this black body. You got to understand this. We're still in chattel slavery, and we're in chattel slavery under the 13th Amendment. People are slaves in the prison industrial complex today. So we had to elect to be that mind of this black body, because we could see this stuff happening. Other people can't even see it. They're not even allowed to see it. They work 80 hours a week and try to raise 3 children. They don't see any of this. You know what I'm saying? So we had to elect to be their body. I know a lot of black people are divisive by nature, but these mixed children are still black. Yes, they do have a place in society. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, we had to get everybody's place in society. But at the same time, these are people and brothers in our nation, the black nation. But I do want to get to all the callers. Hold on, let me do this. I want you to hold on the line. Hold on the line. I'm coming right now. But I do want to play a clip, because just like their forefathers of the past, these same pink parasites are abusing black women, using black women, and killing babies, black babies and stuff like that, still to this day. So I'll play this. I want you guys to call in 516-453-9174. We're going in tonight. Interracial relationships are mind control. Now, this clip is of a black woman and her white boyfriend, and this is the sort of thing you invite racism into your house when stuff like this happens. So let me play this clip.
Get the fuck out. You know what? That's what Trump should do. The second he's elected, give all you motherfuckers your tickets back. You don't like it? Peace. Black Lives Matter, go mad at a fucking Ghana. Go dig for fucking diamonds over there. Have fun.
Do you realize you sound like a racist, right?
Natty, I don't care. You want to know why? Because I'm not up there saying white lives matter. White lives come to the front. Black lives go to the back. I'm just like, hey, what's up? How you doing? But when you want to come at me with your fucking Black Lives Matter and this, that, and the other thing, and the white people need to go to the back because white black people always had to go to the back, now the white people need to do it, fuck your black ass. Get the fuck out. Get out of my country, you're causing the fucking problem. Bye.
I never said any of that.
Here's your ticket back to motherfucking Nigeria. Peace out.
I never said any of that.
The guy you voted for is the number one fucking head of that fucking bullshit. He fucking started the shit, and he fucking incites fucking riots. When he said, I support the Black Lives Matter movement, that's it. You're done. You're done. You're a dumb fucking nigger in my book. You have no fucking value to me.
You realize it makes you sound like a racist when you use racial slurs,
right? Don't be a dumb nigger. Don't be a dumb fucking nigger. Don't be your average fucking shoe shine boy. Get a job. Go to work. Do something other than sitting there making fucking videos about fuck Donald Trump, gonna take my mom's fucking food stamps away, blah, 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 blah. I'm gonna start a war. I'm gonna go to war. Why don't you get a fucking job, you fucking nigga? Jesus Christ. Sound like a racist all I fucking want. I'm right.
Ha ha ha.
So that was just an example of the mentality of these mayonnaise monsters that you're having these relationships with. But we're going to go, the brothers, black men, yeah, I'm going in on y'all next. But 803, you're online with 2RAW4TV. Interracial relationships are mind control. What's your thoughts on that?
Yeah, no doubt, man. It's always a fight topic, bro. We always like supremacy, bro. Whenever you had these discussions, man, it was interesting hearing. I got on when the sister was on and hearing her perspective. Then, bro, last call, he was definitely going to fight. He was definitely going to point salute to him. A lot of people want to look at it for, a lot of women or just people today in this society want to look at it for so-called love. But again, like you said, like we still enslaved people. So we didn't even fucking define love. What the fuck do love mean? Is love loving hip hop shit? Like what the fuck is love? So our people, even that love shit, like we would have to define that and see like what does that actually mean? Because if love means like you want the best for yourself, then goddamn it, you gonna be with your own people. Because the best for us is to be with us. That's period point blank. I mean, if you got any type of wisdom, then you gonna be with your own people. We know that genetically. On a genetic level, we superior. So we got everything within our race. We the only so-called race on this planet that got everything within our race from every color that we want to deal with, even though we know dealing with albinism, that's a disorder, but it still don't matter. We got white within our own race if we wanted to deal with white or a white-skinned person, that is black, that we can produce a superior baby as opposed to being with a pilgrim or cracker. That is a mutation or a recessive individual. So, I mean, I just think, definitely today is being pushed as a heavy propaganda for us to intermix because they have to do that. We don't have to do that. We don't understand who we be on this planet, how we live for eons on this planet without crackers even being on this planet. And actually, like you said, I mean, it's been periods of peace on this planet. Hell yeah, it's been periods of war with us, yeah. But at the same time, it's been long periods of peace. So we just got to know who we be as a people, man. And it's interesting your concept of the mixed children and how you see them. And I definitely agree to a certain extent. I know that as we rise up as a people, we don't have to fight blue-black motherfuckers who never mixed in. We're going to have to fight mixed motherfuckers. We're going to have to fight crackers. We're going to have to fight Chinese, et cetera. It's going to be all type of people that's against our rise of our sovereignty and our supremacy. So it's really just kind of linking up with any brothers and sisters that got the right mind. So if he a mixed brother or sister, he know who he be. Like, he not coming with the bullshit and the confusion, because even though you fighting hard for saying, yeah, our mixed children, they F, it's a lot of them to where, they come through causing major confusion. Like, no, man, my mama got the, we got the shit light on my mama on my desk, even one that's on the other side of the race, they just cause a lot of confusion. They're really, be about confusion, but not all of them. So just, I kind of link up with brothers and sisters just where they at, bro. It's, if they mix or whatever. And I think myth that's being put out by a lot of leaders and brothers and sisters to think that just because we've been over here and we went through this predicament that all of us went through race, that is bullshit, man. Some light-skinned folks don't have no damn cracker up in their body. Our people are truly diverse. Like, we come with every color without mixing with any fucking race. So we got to stop that foolishness. That is foolishness. Certain black people that have been here, went through the prisoner of war, all that shit. Now, we've been raped mentally. Every black person, you can say that mentally, but not every black person in the Americas have been raped that went through their bloodline like that. Stop that foolishness, man. You got some of us soot black. I'm from South Pack. Some of us soot black, man. They ain't never been no damn mixed with no crackers, so we got to stop that foolishness. That is foolishness. But has a lot of our people went through that? Yes, because mentally we've been raped. Mentally, all of our people been raped, molested, and all that other shit. Mentally, but not physically, all of us have been raped, and we come with everything that we need, period. So I just put that out to the people, and to understand that the propaganda is for them because they had zero birth rate. They only last limb. They have to get the best. It makes sense for a cracker to be with a nigga. They think he's smart. It don't make sense for a want niggas to be with a crackhead. That's dumb. Like, it's like you really degrading yourself. I feel holistically. I feel on a spiritual and a goddamn physical level. But definitely on a physical, even if I'm wrong on a so-called spiritual level. So, you know, it is what it is on that thing. Man, our people just got to know who we Aboriginal and Indigenous to this damn planet. And we need to take over all of this shit, man. And we got to get our people on one accord, the ones of us that want the betterment for our people, that want the sovereignty for our people. So, yeah, mixing in with them, I mean, it's no need. Like, it's literally no need. Like,
right.
You know, it's crazy, bro. It's definitely control programming on why our people even think that they got to do that shit, bro. It's like, come on, I mean, I can go in on that case, you know, all day, but sure, it's just no need for us to do that. And the wise amongst us just spread that love to brothers and sisters that's confused, that's thinking that for one. Like you know, some of the myths that we all went through, rape, and we all mixed in, so we might as well keep mixing. Get that shit out of here. And even if we is mixed in,
right.
we go back into deeper into our bloodline. We love ourselves. We ain't with that bullshit. And I mean, just on every level, man. It's like, come on, bro. From white women, just coming from a black man, from white women, they smell like dog. That shit is nasty and stank. Like, how the fuck I'm like get with that sexually? And you smell like a damn dog, bro. I just been in that, being in them. I remember being in the gym or running with them, doing some type of exercise with crackers and shit like that. It's like you smell that shit. It's like, what the fuck is that smell? Like, no way could I be attracted to that. And then they features. It's like, come on, man. The only way that even when we was on a dead level seeing a white girl as attractive is if she was a clone as a black woman. Like, she was on her Kim Kardashian shit. Bitch was goddamn trying to straight clone a black woman, trying to talk like her, walk like her, get a hairstyle, nigga, get a fat ass like her, all that. So why would we want a clone of the black woman when we can get that ourselves? But on every level, man, they inferior to us, and our people just need to keep it real and let our people know that. And the ones that are wise and, you know, take heed to that and get back on point. Because I know some people too, man, I don't think that we necessarily should condemn our brothers and sisters that went through that because, like you said, I mean, we're still going through the slavery, so a lot of things that we do to each other as people, I mean, it's under a slave mindset. But I know a lot of them I know a couple of them that did that, a sister and a brother, a couple of brothers, and they getting in the knowledge themselves. So they, you know, they understand it. And, you know, good to me, when I break it down, they're like, oh, yeah, that shit makes sense, blah, blah, blah. And, you know, they on the path of like, hell nah, you know, I'm sticking to my own. Like, I'm, you know, dealing with my own. I ain't dealing with that foolishness no more. So it's just as simple as that. We got a lot of stuff to deal with as a people, period. We under they system, so it's called confusion. The whole point of them building the United States was to break up the black family, but to enslave the black family. So, come on, man, they inferior. They got to do that. They parasites. That's their nation. So,
right.
That is what it
right.
is. I can keep commenting on that, bro, but you got it, though.
I want you to hold on line. You're doing great things. That's the bro tie. Hey, where are you calling from tonight?
Yeah, the UMC, man, South Tech, bro. You already know.
All right. Hey, well, I want to play this. Let me tell you, it's going to be a big month. Revolution is happening this month. 2RAW4TV is going to be on the front lines. On the 30th, there's going to be a meet and greet at 675 Metropolitan Parkway for the Huey P. Newton Gun Club of Atlanta. So be there at 7. There's going to be a lot of, you know, networking, refreshment, and 2RAW4TV will be reporting live from there. So come out to the Huey P. Newton Gun Club, Chapter of Atlanta Meet and Greet on the 30th, 675 Metropolitan Parkway at 7 p.m. Wear black. Also, next broadcast, I have the honor of speaking to one of the foremost thinkers of black progressive movement, Dr. Claude Anderson. He's going to be on 2RAW4TV. You may have seen him in Hidden Colors 2. You may have read Powernomics. His new book is called a black history reader, 101 questions you never thought to ask. And it is riveting. He really details the subjugation of what's happening right now. He's going to be on 2RAW4TV next week at 11 p.m., 101 questions that you need to know. So we're going to go in with Dr. Claude Anders. And here's a clip of film in Hidden Colors, too.
Why is it Koreans are controlling black hair care? That 85 cents out of every dollar goes to Asians, to Koreans. Why are Koreans and Chinese controlling black hair care and black hair care products? Because you're not practicing good economics. So I go to a Chinese place, and I ask them to buy something from black folks. They won't do it. Some black distributors came right here to Washington, D.C., to H Street right over here, and said, we'd like to meet with some merchants, sell you some products. And the Asian said, what do you want to sell? He said, we'll sell you some of the same products you got on your shelf right now. We'll sell it to you and give you a 25 to 30% discount. The Asian said, we're not interested. The Asian said, but with a 25, 30% discount, you're still not interested? They said, no. They said, why not? The Asian said, you black won't understand. It ain't the money. It's that we only buy from our own people. You black are the only people that buy from in and everybody. Asians, you black won't understand. It ain't the money. It's that we only buy from our own people. You black are the only people that buy from in and everybody.
So mark your calendars for the 28th. Dr. Claude Anderson will be on 2RAW4TV. 101 questions you never thought to ask. We're talking about interracial relationships. They are mind control and have been mind control for since King people have been here and have created this dynamic of interracial. When they stole the title from white, from the Moors, they stole, that's not even a racial identification. So stop saying white. Pink people have created this illusion that they are on some sort of level playing field. And black people have bought into it. And they don't understand it, really. See, they only gave us a context of slavery and said this is what freedom is. But the 40-hour work week wasn't created prior to the end of chattel slavery. It was created afterwards to confuse the now free slave that this was freedom, that this was ownership, that you can even own anything. Dr. Malachi York should have shown you that ownership is an illusion. Interracial relationships are mind control. What do you guys think? Call in 516-453-9174. We're going in tonight. I have a lot of callers on the line. I promise you I'm going to get to everybody. Hold on. Do this. 770, you're on air with 2RAW4TV. Interracial relationships are mind control. What's your thoughts?
Palmetto, what's going on, brother?
Hey, what's going on, family?
Hey, this is Ari, brother.
Oh, what's good? Hey, Ari, what's going on?
Hey, nothing much, brother, nothing much.
Yeah, live it up, man.
Give my 2 cents. Yeah, Lieutenant Black.
Hey, that's what it is, man.
One second. But yeah, I just wanted to give my 2 cents, brother. So everybody that's listening, y'all have to at least know this fact here. You cannot call yourself pro-black or pro-anything that's close to pro-black if you are dating outside of your race. That's point blank, period. You're not pro-black if you're dating outside your race. Second of all, you got to know some of the reasons why they're pushing this interracial relationship thing, man. One, you know, that their time is up. Honestly, they're not going to be here too much longer. We know that. But that's why they have to procreate with the true original people of the planet so they can preserve their race, so they can be here longer, and for many other things. But those are the that's one of the main things. These people are trying to preserve their race. They're trying to, you know what I'm saying, be of that divine bloodline. You know what I'm saying? And all of us are falling for it. Well, not all of us, but the ones who feel that it's okay to procreate with these other races, white people especially, pink people especially. But we have to know that, you know, we have to procreate with our own bloodlines and continue that divine energy, that divine DNA, so we can continue to, you know, take back what's ours. Like brother was saying right before me, we got to take back what's ours. But, you know, it's all to slow down that divine energy, brother. And that, I think that's the main thing, what it is to me. So, yeah, for everybody that's listening, you know, you cannot call yourself pro-black or anything like that. I know even brother Umar Johnson was saying the same thing. I know he was getting a lot of fire for that, you know what I'm saying, just from people who are like, oh, no, you know, it's okay, love is love. No, it's not, because you have to know, you have to have knowledge of self and know who you really are, black people, because we aren't just humans, you know what I'm saying, what they're telling us. We are way more than that. Just, you know what I'm saying, just to keep it in
right.
That, I ain't even going to go further with that. But it starts with knowledge
right.
of self, you know what I'm saying? Like when I was, you know, when I was growing up in elementary school, it was like 80% white, maybe 20% black or something like that. So that's all I saw was white people. So, of course, you know, in elementary school, I'm looking at these white girls like, man, this is the best thing in the world, but not knowing about my own people and my own race, you know what I'm saying, until I got to middle school, high school. I'm like, yeah, this is what, how it's supposed to be. I'm supposed to be with my people, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
But, yeah, I just think it's an agenda, brother, to push this interracial thing, to make it seem like it's all right. But all I'm saying is...
Oh, yeah, it is definitely... Big Zion, shout out to Live It Up, Ant-Man. Hey, matter of fact, I'll play that track a little bit later.
Hey,
Lieutenant Black,
right,
one of the hottest
right.
tracks out. Hey, congratulations. One of the hottest tracks out there in the streets of Atlanta right now. If you don't know Atlanta, if you don't know this song. So, Lieutenant Black, we're going to go in on that. Go ahead.
Yeah, just one more thing, man. And this is because I watch a lot of movies. You know, honestly, they put a lot of secrets in movies. We know that. They put a lot of stuff in that. But it was this one thing that I saw in this Transformers movie. It was one of the quote-unquote evil robots, the Transformers, whatever you want to call it. But it was one thing that he said that stuck out to me. And it said, all of these species mixing with species, and it's upsetting the cosmic balance, and the creators don't like it. Basically, all of these, we pretty much seem like we're the only ones that don't get it. All of the animals, they procreate with what they are. You don't see lions sleeping with cheetahs because they want something slim, thick. They stay what they own. You know what I'm saying? They stay what they own. But we seem to be the only ones that don't get it. So all of these species mixing with species, like, is literally upsetting the cosmic balance. And we have to stick with our own if we want to, you know what I'm saying, if we want to push our dominance. So
I want to say about current interracial couples. I feel that, you know, you have to know that person's role ultimately, you know, is going to be different in black society. So, you know, you got to understand that dynamic is going to be different. So what do you guys think? Call in 516-453-9174. I want to get to all the callers. Remember to press 1 if you have a question or comment. Also, if you're online, I see a lot of callers online. I am going to get to you guys. But if you're online, go ahead and follow the show. go ahead and make a profile, follow the show, because Dr. Claude Anderson is going to be on next week. 101 questions you never thought to ask, so we're going to go in on that next week. 509, you're on the air with 2RAW4TV. Interracial relationships are mind control. What's your thoughts on that? 509.
I'm down here.
You here?
All right.
Are you online, 509? 509, last time, last calling. You may have went to sleep, y'all. Let's sing a lullaby for him. So, 818, you're on air with 2RAW4TV. What's your thoughts? Interracial relationships are mind control. Absolutely can hear you.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Yes. I'm having
Hold up, turn down the volume in the background. Turn down the volume because you're creating an echo effect.
Is it better
yes.
now? Okay.
Yes.
I was pretty much listening in, and this is asked about me. I just got off work, and I was able to catch a lot of what was said. Knowledge of self is definitely important. And I say that because, like the other gentleman had just spoke on, when you don't have knowledge of self, everything seems right. You see what I'm saying? Oh, yeah, look at that. And you start looking at shit that you shouldn't even be looking at. You see what I'm saying? And when you actually find out who you are and why you are, you see what I'm saying? It's a whole different feeling within once you know who you are. And I say that from a deep experience because I dated a white person, and that was very strange. Knowing what I know, being who the fuck I am. You see what I'm saying? It's just like, damn. You know what I mean? I did that. So having this communication with everybody and actually just listening rather to everybody communicate is deep. I just wanted to pretty much comment on that. You know, I was very young. Like, I had just started dating. You see what I'm saying? So a lot of that was going on, but it seemed to be a safe thing. And like, again, when you don't know who you are and you don't have the proper, you know, black background as far as everybody knowing and unifying and shit like that, you see what I'm saying? You're gonna slip. But to be able to actually get back on track and know who you are, that's the most important thing. Because right now I think a lot of people are starting to wake up, but it seems to be, like, not fast enough. You know, the cosmic change has definitely happened with all these eclipses and all these things, but it's amazing how many people have gone through what the gentleman just described and what I'm describing and how we were able to bounce back from it. You see what I'm saying? Like, bounce back real quick. Like, what the fuck was that? And then other people, you end up walking next to them. And you see them with a white person or, you know, how you call a pink person. And you're like, damn, man, wake up. And it's like, you can't wake them up, though. It's like, maybe they never will. And you have to just watch it. I don't know. It's a sad, sad reality. I had to get in on this. I was like, damn, because that's what I was just talking to a family member about. I asked my cousin, hey, you like white women? And something just came over me to ask him, and he just stopped. Yeah, and I said, damn, son, don't give a one. Please, I started begging this man not to give it a white woman. And I don't even know how else to educate him on why. You see what I'm saying? Other than, you know, the things we're talking about, but he's not even that deep in it yet. You see what I'm saying? He
right.
still go to church and believe in the white Jesus. So it was a lot of work. It's a lot of work.
Well,
I pretty much made a comment to say that I'm happy to be in this room.
That's what's up. Where are you calling from tonight?
I'm actually calling from Washington, D.C.
All right. That's what it is. But I want you to hold on for 1 second because we're going in on that. I do want to get to all the callers. So you guys, if you're online listening, go ahead, call in 516-453-9174. If you can't get in on one phone, call with your other phone. And get on board tonight because interracial relationships are mind control. And I do want to go in on that. Matter of fact, let me do this. I do want to play another clip. And I want to talk about black men as well and their role in this, like you were touching on, sis. And I do want to get in on that. You guys call in 516-453-9174. Who is the Queen of Spades? That what is that? What is even that? It's not spades. It's not hearts. It's not parcheesi. This is something different. So we're going to talk about that. But let me play this. Quote. You guys, go ahead. Call 516-453-9174. Press 1 if you have a comment or question. Now, you know, I started the trend of being real. Of course, I did start the trend of being real. But raw, you know, and raw. And, you know, I got raw last show and talked about my situation with polygamy and that dynamic. Now, I did deal with a white woman in high school, you know what I'm saying, like many other people that were in situations where there were a lot of white people at their school, you know. And that was, you know, very briefly, not even anything, you know, physical even happened. But it's programming. It's programming. You know what I'm saying? It's all mental programming that they give you through movies, through media, different things of that nature that makes you, like, you're dealing with someone on, you know, common ground and, you know, that, you know, so we had to take into account that they always have wanted us to be the labor class of this nation. So what do you guys think? Call in 516-453-9174. I am going to play. Oh, this is one of the things about live radio. It's always, always, always sporadic. Always. Let me play this clip real quick. You guys go ahead, call in. Put it on Facebook, Snapchat, Instagram. Let them know that it's going down on 2RAW4TV. This is a clip of a black man.
Story that came out in the Metro. This is actually a UK publication, but this story pertains to something that happened here in the U.S. January 25th, 2018. I'll leave the link to this article in the description box. Racist beat black man up from Marion. White woman. Swirlers are simply not safe. Just not safe. This horrific photo shows the swollen face of a black man allegedly beaten to a pulp by a racist for getting engaged to a white woman. Darren Glover, 44, was attacked over plans to marry his white girlfriend in a jail ceremony at the prison where he is serving a sentence. He is said to have been battered by corrections officer. A corrections officer did this to him. Michael Baxter, 49, at Appalachian Correctional Institute in Sneeds, Florida, during July 2015. He is said to have told colleague Sharon Watts that nigger didn't need to be marrying a white woman. What is this, 1955? But this just go to show you, we may be in a different era, but the attitudes are all the same. He needs to be in confinement all along. This is what his correction officer is saying. See, sometimes these correction officers are bigger criminals than the actual criminals in prison. Watts is currently giving evidence against her former colleague, reports the Northwest Florida Daily News. Now, this is what he looked like before he was beaten. Ooh, he looks like a whole different person with that swollen face. Mm-mm-mm. But that's what he gets for swirling. You're going to pay for that mess. Glover is said to have angered Baxter over untied shoelaces during a photo shoot the previous day. He was led into an office in the prison and beaten up. It is alleged. Watts heard his scream of pain and initially helped Baxter cover up his crime by collaborating a false use of force report. See? You see how they falsify? They do the same thing that the cops do on the outside. So the correction officers beat the hell and kill these prisoners, and then they falsify a report about the incident. So there was somebody in there that was willing to help this racist correctional officer cover up this beating. She eventually owned up, explaining the crying and whining. They haven't been removed. They are still there. This was eating at me, so they got a bout of guilt, and I had to get some relief. Baxter maintained he used appropriate force and denies falsifying records, as well as using cruel or unusual punishment on an inmate. A judge is expected to deliver a verdict in the coming days. Oh, not guilty. Not guilty, because not guilty. Look, they get people off of things when black people aren't even in jail. This guy is in jail. He probably got even less protection. We have none. So what makes you think some black guy in prison got some protection? Get it? Not guilty. We already know the outcome of this. The judge is going to come back and said the right amount of force was used, blah, blah, blah. The same thing all the other devil judges around this country say. Nothing new. Please leave your comment and subscribe. Don't forget to hit on the notification bell twice. Also, join me over on Black Junction TV and blackspot.com. Boy, I tell you what, there ain't no white woman on this planet worth all of this. Not one. Peace, family.
Calling now, 516-453-9174. Next week, Dr. Claude Anderson will be with 2RAW4TV, a Black History Reader. 101 questions you never thought to ask is his current release. A lot of you may have read Power Anonymous, but he's going to be with us next week. So go ahead and follow or subscribe to this channel on blogtalkradio.com/2RAW4TV. If you're online still, you need to call in. 516-453-9174. We're going in tonight. Interracial relationships. I got a couple people on the line. Anybody else want to add anything?
The people that are
online? The people that are online that I got as callers.
I got something I gotta say.
Okay.
Like I said, kind of like before, we keep talking about how you're not pro-black if you mix. If you interracial, we mix with whatever. Why are people?
Mm-hmm.
Having sex with these people, okay, that we call quote-unquote pink, and black women are sleeping with white men or not non-black men making biracial children, and then they turn around and say things like, all you black men are attracted to mostly light-skinned or light-skinned biracial women. And then the same thing happens. See, I'm from Washington, so I see it everywhere. In fact, the majority of the brothers date nothing but outside of their race. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
And then we have a lot of people who are a product of whatever you want to call it. Not swirl, but there's a lot of mixed people up here that are black mixed, and they try to date black men, and some black men won't even give you, who are a pro or a whole tap or whatever, they'll look at you like you're not even black and don't want to date you because whatever reason.
Yeah.
So,
well, they're mind controlled. They're mind controlled. They're still sleeping. There's a lot of people that wear RBG, red, black, green, and, you know, that, you know, claim different things, but they are still asleep. All, anybody that's black is black, you know, as far as, you know, we are the dominant gene. So, you know, you're still, you're black, you know what I'm saying? Like, biracial people, no. Let's take out these labels. Let's defragment our mind. Let's clean out our mind. Let's give our mind validation that it is supreme. You know, we have to understand what's going on. There's always a power dynamic when you talk about interracial relationships, you know, and white men play on this, as you heard from the clips. It is a cultural thing. It is a, you know, it's, you know, just because it's not happening on the movies, see, black people relate their experiences to pink people because of Hollywood movie magic. They feel that they, you know, they connect with these beings that are decent people, and they forget what just happened. You know what I'm saying? They forget about everything, and you know, they don't even think. These people don't have thought process. So
why are we creating?
You know, and I understand that. That's my people. That's my people. But you know, we got to understand the predicament that we're in. We had to elect to be the mind of this body. So I don't care who defines what you know you're black and all this. That's a garbage. We are black. There's different degrees of it, and we definitely had to, see our society as the way we see fit, you know, to include people that are black, you know what I'm saying, and have that background. Because white is not even, it's only a placer gene. It's like a bookmark. There, you know, white people come from weaker black genes, from different concoctions of DNA. And
Can I say something personally? Okay, if I'm not saying that ain't true, but what about women that may have fathers?
What about the women?
Black women that have white fathers or fathers with white in them that are trying to bring back black kids through black men, and their kids keep coming out white. Or whiter. What's up with that? If the black race,
Right.
But that's petty. I really didn't want to know that. I really wanted to get to something that is my own personal pain, and I really want to express it because it's kind of pissing me off. Like, I don't understand. Like I was saying before, like some of these women who create, and men, create these light-skinned mixed children, and then in these pro-black groups, they are the ones being attacked. We could say all day long that they are proud, and they are mostly proud to be black, otherwise they wouldn't be in them groups. But there are real attacks on them where our own people are saying that they are not black. They're saying if you got a white parent and a black parent, you are not black, is what is being taught. And a lot of people are starting to take that and run with it, and now here we have created a bigger division.
I don't subscribe to that classification of we had to understand those black people's role in society. Outside of that, they are black. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, stop dividing us and wanting us to shrink. That's a self-destruct module that we have been programmed with. This self-destruct module where we start being so divisive. You know, And it starts with the diet, starts with the meat. Let's keep it real. It starts with the meat and ingesting tortured animals, and it's with the TV and computer programming, YouTube programming, algorithms, and it's this complete mental control. You know what I'm saying, of black people, and we had to get out of these. We had to stop being distracted so easily by nuances in other people's thoughts. That is insane. Nobody should be cheering on black death and deception. And this is what interracial relationships, you know, have come to. That's why you had the royal wedding, and there's a half black woman that's the bride. This is how they want to somehow keep on perpetuating pink power through light-skinned people. We have to understand that through their genealogy, supposedly. We have to understand that, and now we have to deal with that dynamic, you know, in our society, you know what I'm saying, because that definitely can't, you know, we're not going to have, you know, the ruling class like that, but we're going to have a special place for people that, you know, that know they're black, first of all. They have to be black, you know, but, you know, understand that they do have that history in their family. And like I said, those people are just a bookmark. They don't have any real genetic coding that can sustain after generation after generation after generation, because it depends on where you are. You know, a lot of times black people are attacked more in colder climates in America, because that is a natural weakness against, you know, is colder weather. You know what I'm saying? But at the same time, we have to understand what we're dealing with. What do you guys think? Call in 516-453-9174. I heard the brother. I think it was Ty. You guys, something you want to add to that, bro?
Oh, yeah, bro. I say this, man. I think, I love your perspective on it, though, bro, because I see where you're coming from with it. It's like I was saying, it's like the mixed person has to know that they're black. Unfortunately, that's you know, they set up the interracial thing. Again, it's in their benefit for them to get with us. It's not in our benefit for us to get with them. But that go back to knowledge itself. I mean, if our folk have knowledge itself, then they already know what's popping. Like, there's no need. You know what I'm talking about? So they know what's up with that. But unfortunately, we ain't putting this war situation that we still in, as Aboriginal and Indigenous people, to this side of the hemisphere, to the whole planet, but especially to the Americas, they still got the war going on. We still up in this war, and it's more subtle and more covert, because that's how they twisted up when they had the war against each other to figure out how they were going to deal with us continuing to enslave us and destroy us, our family structures especially. You only destroy people, you can destroy their family structures. So any black tribe on the planet that ain't been enslaved or conquered, you'll see they got a powerful family structure. They don't got no mixing or none of that craziness going on. But with us, you know, we got that because we've been, like I said, if anything, you could say all of our people have been psychologically raped, but not physically, not all our people physically. But yeah, I like the way that you deal with that scenario. I would say yeah, that's something that's another route that we can look at it. But I say too, with that sister, man, like, she got to get over. See, I don't necessarily say this part that I don't fully agree with you on, to say that, like, some of the brothers in the group or the sisters in the group, that when you say that they might be not fully woke or whatever, they is. But see, we got different politics as a people. See, some of our people know, like, listen, like, fuck that shit. We just want all black. Like, they don't want to deal with that. So I can't be mad at them brothers and sisters for not wanting to deal with that, because it was a strategic move for the cracker to go into certain ones of our women's and to have that seed go back into the tribe and to take our heritage and shit like that, that did happen too. So it's not act like the mulatto wasn't used as a tools for the cracker. So, I mean, these are things that, you know, we just got to deal with as a people, but that's why I say, I mean, you got to deal with folks on how they come with it. Because, I mean, like I said, we're going to have blue-black brothers and sisters never being mixed or whatever. That's going
to... Oh, yeah, absolutely.
That's already against us, and that's going to continue to stand against us. That's the Yacoubian seed. That's
exactly.
Why, you know, the Nation of Islam teaching on that is that Yacoubian. Yacoub was actually a black scientist. He was a god that grafted the cracker onto the planet. So we just gotta have, you know, it's the value system of the black people, man. Even with, you know, relationship dynamics. I mean, you know, from monogamy, polygamy, whatever. Like, it's the value system that the black person take on whether or not it's gonna be empowering for us as a race. Because I mean, just getting,
yeah.
You know, just two black people getting together and, you know, and considering that shit black love when they upholding this cracker system, it's like, well, hell no, that's not my definition of no love or none of that shit. So we really gotta give purpose and meaning to everything within his life for ourselves as a people. Right now we on a slave level. We on a slave level, so we let these people define love for us. They define black for us. They define everything for us. So I just like the way you put it, bro. But I do. I say to that sister, I mean, you just gotta understand certain black folks. I wouldn't say all of them dumb. It's just like, nah, they want their own, and our people have the right to be sovereign and say, nah, we just really want to deal with us. Like, but I say it like this: it's plenty of black people. Like, you gotta find the black. You can't see, that's a cracker mentality too. That'd be like me saying I'm Aboriginal, this is more, and I'm enforcing that on a brother and sister that say like, nah, I don't really want to rock with the more term or whatever. I don't do nothing like that. See, we gotta learn how to have compassion and love for each other as a people, and not be enforcing shit on each other. I mean, of course we can have dialogue to, you know, we deal with us intelligently having different strategies on how to deal with this thing. But I mean, you gotta go amongst black people that's gonna embrace you. So don't if you you know, dealing with that and black folks that's pigs, they're not receptive to that. You gotta go against them amongst the brothers and sisters that is gonna deal with you. You know, so man, I would say like boom him. You know, I definitely see what he's saying too. So I wouldn't be against a brother and sister that's dealing with that scenario. Like I said, I don't condemn brothers and sisters. I speak passionately about it to let brothers and sisters know so we can use our intelligence to help these brothers and sisters, because we in war right now.
Mm-hmm.
So a lot of us, we doing a lot of out of straight ignorance, man, out of straight ignorance. So, Trisha, we just got to be wise on how we, you know, articulate ourselves and move and let our people know what's going on. Like, literally what's going on, this whole system was built on really breaking up this bullshit confusion. The cracker going, got to put his seed into his sister. And you know what's crazy, too? Dr. Ali Muhammad did an excellent lecture on you know, just dealing with races and race mission and stuff like that. He was saying how the black woman, black women who haven't, you know, went through you know, mixing and things like that, they can't even really receive a black woman, I mean a white man's seed without the body actually trying to attack it and kill it. The only thing that the way that they make that happen is they use some type of drug to suppress her body. But it's called like erythroblastosis or something like that. I get the spelling for it. But that's just to show you, like, bro was saying, like, ain't no damn blind supposed to be with no cheetah, so ain't no black person supposed to be with no crackers, man. You know, they genetic mutations. It was a limited experiment for them being on this planet. They're not supposed to be on this planet that long. They don't have sustainable genes. They parasitic. It just is what it is. You're not supposed to be with them. So I mean, just go for any of the brothers and sisters online that just go for people that, you know, receptive to you. That's receptive to your energy. You know what I'm talking about? So that's all I gotta say, bro.
No doubt. And if you're listening online, call in right now. But before you do call in, go ahead, follow the show. Dr. Claude Anderson is going to be on the show next week. It's going to be something that you have to hear. This is a discussion that we had to have, 101 questions that you never thought to ask Dr. Claude Anderson. But let me say this. And you're absolutely correct. You're absolutely correct with that. And, you know, of course, we're going to have counsel and different things, and things are going to work out in different nations. You know, we got to understand that black people are many nations, not just one nation, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, there's different things. Everybody in the world right now, the billions and billions of people that are in the world right now, can actually live comfortably in Texas. So you're talking about the world, you're talking about the black people, which, you know, of course we're going to fruitful and multiply. The black baby boom has begun. There are going to be quadruple the amount of black people there are in just a couple years. So we have to understand what's happening right now. You know what I'm saying? We have to understand that. But it's not enough for us to have more babies than pink people. That's not enough. Black supremacy is the answer. What do you guys think? Call in 516-453-9174. We're going in on this subject. Also wanted to let you know that on the 30th, on the last Saturday of this month, Huey P. Newton Gun Club Atlanta is having a meet and greet at 7 p.m. at 675 Metropolitan Parkway in Atlanta, Georgia. If you're in Atlanta, you already know where that is. So it's going to be major. It's going to be refreshments there. You're going to get a chance to commune with the Huey P. Newton Gun Club. So you definitely want to be a part of that. Wear black. And it's going to be something major for the city of Atlanta. So come there the last Saturday of this month, June 30th. And what you're saying is 100% correct. But we have to understand that all black people are not of the same nation, and I do understand that. You know what I'm saying? As long as we have an understanding, we could talk about anything. You know what I'm saying? There's
right,
no
right.
limit to. You know, there's going to be different ideas and ideology and different things of that nature.
But
you know, saying I understand that, and you don't have to deal with that if you don't want to deal with that. You know what I'm saying?
Yep.
So,
because
you got space, you got room. You know what I'm saying? You finally have freedom, not Juneteenth, but freedom. You finally have that. You feel me? What do you guys think? Hey, if you hear me right now, I see a lot of people just called in. You only have 15 minutes to call in, so call in right now, 516-453-9174. I see a lot of people called in. If you hear my voice, you're part of the revolution. Press 1 if you hear me speak. If you can hear me talking right now, I want to make sure I'm completely audible. If you have a comment or question, let me know. But we have to understand that, you know, the dynamic of power that has just been projected onto pink people. And this dynamic disables any sort of realistic relationship of being with somebody. It's all of illusion. You know what I'm saying? This person is wearing your clothes. You know what I'm saying? He's wearing your clothes. He's in your house. Like, That dynamic is just false. It has just been pushed onto people and normalized. And, you know, now they're on a killing spree because they are losing track. They are dying off. All pink people will be extinct by 2020. We have to understand what's happening right now. We have to understand what's happening right now. But what do you guys think? Call in 516-453-9174. I promise you I'm going to get to all the callers. 509, you're on the line with 2RAW4TV. What's your thoughts? Interracial relationships are mind control.
Peace, God. Am I on?
Peace.
Hello?
Yeah, I hear you.
Hello?
Yeah.
I'm better. Let me see if I get this phone working better. Is that any better?
Yeah, I can hear you.
All right. I wanted to pause. This is Ndudu Wezikana out here in Washington State. And I wanted
peace
to posit
God.
A different.
Black supremacy.
Peace God. Black supremacy. I wanted to posit a different opinion on, especially about the idea that black people who are in interracial relationships are not pro-black. I see that
Okay.
You know, there's a lot of realities behind the fact that our opinions and what we like and what we gravitate toward as far as beauty are imposed upon by Europeans and their culture. But I think that a lot of the relationships that a lot of brothers and sisters find themselves in might be a little bit more random than what we're given, what we're generalizing and making it out to be. I really, as a black person who is a pro-black person, who is in a relationship with a white woman, I'm saying, I stand on my pro-blackness. I stand on my desire for my people. But, you know, my situation has found me in just a different situation. I think that a lot of what we're doing as far as saying what people can and can't be due to their relationships might be causing a lot of division between us. I think that there are a lot of black people who have a lot of goals toward us, who may be mulatto, maybe in a different, relationship, a racial relationship and things like that. But I think we generalize a lot. A lot of our original black liberators were in relationships with white people, and it didn't stop any of them from really doing what they could to see about their people. I know that there's, once again, we have a lot of work to do on our mentalities, the reasons why we're in relationships, how we go about really finessing those. There's a lot of relationships you see sisters get into. Yeah, they're getting beat up. A lot of the males are getting indoctrinated into the culture of white supremacy and really getting messed up. But there are, and I'm not trying to okay it. I'm not trying to, you know, I really don't believe in them, even though I'm in one. I don't know if they work so well for, you know, it's not really the thing to do. But I find that my situation granted me the opportunity to know this person as a person. I think racial relationships are more social than they are familial. I think unless, of course, you have that culture, but I just wanted to posit that it's not.
That's what's up, Wazakani. I'm glad that you're on the line. Big time shout out to. Hey, where are you calling from today?
Washington. We're still out here in Washington.
Okay. Hey, that's what it is, brother, man. Hey, but I want to add this onto the conversation, on what you're saying. There's so much space we got to have. When I was talking about dynamic and people understanding the dynamic of black people, I was thinking about you. I was thinking about, you know, black people, you know what I'm saying? We have to come, because one thing we're not going to do is terrify, destroy people that, you know, that we're gonna have.
But we have to deal with issues. We have to deal with issues.
We gotta understand what black rulership is.
Yes, sir.
Because we're gonna rule over all races. You know what I'm saying? Black people are gonna be rulers over all races. So it's not. We just have to understand the dynamic. You know what I'm saying? If both parties in an interracial relationship can understand that things are going to be different. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
We could work from there. But what do you guys think? What do you guys think? 516-453-9174. But yeah, I that's what I'm saying. We got to understand that mixed children are black. You know what I'm saying? Mixed children are black. Even if you don't, you could do your own thing somewhere else. But as far as like, you know, different pockets and big different collectives will have their understandings. You know what I'm saying? So, that's what it is. You know what I'm saying? But what do you guys think? Call in 516-453-9174. If you have a comment or question, you know, press 1. If you have a story or you're in a relationship right now, press 1. Interracial relationships are mind control. And this is what I have to say about that. There's a lot of people in interracial relationships, you know, that, and like I was saying, the inner workings are not, you know, drenched in pink subjugation, white supremacy. You know, it's pure. And it's, and we got to understand what black is, you know what I'm saying? There's what black is. We got to expand black, you know what I'm saying? Expand what black is. You know, what do you guys think? Call in 516-453-9174. Press 1 if you have a comment or question. And subscribe to the show if you're online right now. We're going in on this subject. So let me do that. I'm going to play a clip. 856 online with 2RAW4TV. What's your interracial relationships? Are they mind control?
Hello, can you hear me, my boy?
Yeah.
All right, I feel you on interracial relations. Can you hear me? Are we talking?
Yeah, I hear you.
All right, I just want to make sure. You know what I'm saying? I'm not an African American, but I'm a man of color.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And I'm gonna tell you right now. I love every color, but I ran through more difficulty with African American women. I had an African American woman that did not even know my race, but my name. I'm gonna give you my name. My name is Jose. Jose Luis. You can't tell you what my race is from that. You know what I'm saying? And I live down south, so I catch a lot of animosity from both races.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? I ain't got no problem with no race. I love you. I'm a veteran. I fought for this country,
right.
And I love my country. I love my brothers and I love my sisters. I'm just tired of the alcohol, especially, you know what I'm saying? And sometimes when I see an African American woman, it feels like I got to go to the extreme to please her.
Right. Where are you calling from? Where are you calling from?
Well, I'm calling
from
South Carolina. I'm calling from
South
Carolina, but I'm from New York.
And let me say this. I'm gonna add on to what you're saying. Because I understand what you're saying. I understand your frustration. It is
I'm not frustrated. I'm just acknowledging what I see. I'm not even mad at it because that's not it at all. That is not my ordeal. That's their own ordeal. I'm not mad at it. I'm just telling you what I see.
Well, I hear your voice. You sound like a black man. You know.
That's the whole thing. That's what they get from me. They get that from me.
Well, you phonetically look
like a
black person.
Yes, I do.
Do you have?
I look like
this is what I gotta say about that. I mean, you are part of the nation. I don't care what you want to call yourself.
I know I am.
As far as like us embracing each other, we gotta do that. We gotta get rid of the divisive stuff that they put in our way. Like you're this and you're that and all these other weird titles.
I see where you're coming from. I see where you're coming from, my brother. I know that.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I used to run a gun with every and anybody. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
And it's
right.
Like, hey. You know what I'm saying? It's like, yo, man, you know what I'm saying? I don't keep I go ahead. I'm sorry.
No, you're being that's raw, man, and that's real, you know, and I'm coming from I came from South Carolina to Atlanta. A lot of people know my story. I love South Carolina because of the police terrorism,
I'm from
things of that
New
nature.
York. I'm from New York.
And then I came out of
Savannah.
All right.
Yeah, I'm well traveled.
No doubt.
And I'm gonna say that I've been everywhere and anywhere.
Oh hi. Michael.
I've seen a difference in natures.
Hey.
Well, I think somebody has something to say. What are you saying? Who is this? Is this
Love you.
Hold on for 1 second, bro. New York family. Hold on for 1 second. I hear what you're saying. I want you to add on to the conversation too, but I think someone was saying something.
Go ahead.
That was probably me. I didn't know I was still in the queue. Black supremacy. I'm gone, black.
Okay, no doubt, family.
I can't hear the whole conversation. I just hear you.
Okay, no doubt. Yeah, no doubt, no doubt. But I feel you. I feel you 100%. And, you know, I feel you 100% on what you're saying. Definitely. Because we're given this contrived thing by programming. You know what I'm saying? A lot of black women are programmed. But I do want to talk about this. I want to talk about...
I'm going to drop a jewel on you. It's not even about that. I have nothing against homosexuality, but right now that is taking over the nature of every man. Where are my kids at?
Well, there's a lot of false minorities and all that politics.
I'm
going to
tell you right now.
Mm-hmm.
Yo, right now, a lot of men ain't being met.
Hold on for one second. I do want you to hold on the line. I'm going to cue you in a second. But I'm going to cue you in a second, family, so just hold on because I do have to get to all the callers. And say this because there's only 5 minutes in the live stream. You guys call in right now, 516-453-9174. You could only do that for 4 more minutes tonight. So if you're online listening, call in right now. Press 1 if you hear my voice. And let me say this. The Queen of Spades, I want to talk about that because I'm going to go in on the black man as well. You know, the Queen of Spades is a secret subculture, which, you know, in pink society, they never tell you. They're real subcultures that they have for generations and generations. They don't talk about that, but you can put one and one together, one plus one together. Understand that, you know, these are heirs to slave madams that, you know, they look for unconscious sleeping black men, and they use them for sexual pleasure, clout. A lot of them are clout chasing. Kim Kardashian. They do a lot of things to, you know, with this black man. They, you know, the propaganda that they put out there is that they are subservient to black supremacy, and that's the propaganda that they put out there. But at the same time, they use that power dynamic, and a lot of people have got messed up over that power dynamic of the Queen of Spades. Now, the Queen of Spades is one of the more powerful cards, and this is when you talk about any game of cards, they do normally tattoo that on their body somewhere. And there's a lot of people don't know why they do that or whatever. That's part of the that's part of this culture of these guys, of these women that use black men for sexual gratification and clout. You know what I'm saying? So a lot of we had to recognize that. That is a subculture that is happening. There's 90 seconds to call, so you definitely want to call in right now, 516-453-9174. It is a gang of people that understand they had to, in order for pink subjugation to go on, they had to go about it. So white people aren't opposed to interracial relationships and to dating. You know what I'm saying? Pink people aren't opposed to that because it's the only chance. And that's not even a chance. It's not even a chance. So it's the only chance they have to sustain going into the future is by interracial relationships. And they do that all the time. They do the interracial relationships all the time. They have been through history, you know, because they know that's to maintain their bloodline. You know what I'm saying? So we have to understand the dynamic, the power dynamic that's being played. Queen of queen of spades. Most of them have a of playing card, queen of spades with the Q in the middle, and so we had to recognize what's going on with that. You guys call in 516-453-9174. We're going in on that subject. Press 1 if you have a comment or question. We're going in on that subject. Hold on. Let me give you a definition that's propagated of the Queen of Spades, or what they try, the propaganda that they put out over memes and over different things since people have discovered this subculture again. The simple but elegant symbol, they're talking about the Queen of Spades, is showing up on the ankle of so many white women today, both young and mature. It represents her open acceptance of black supremacy and makes clear her sexual preferences to the entire world, and in many cases to her cuckold white husband as well. His acceptance commonly follows with enforced chastity and submission to both wife and her black lover. The harmony that is achieved is being called the new black paradigm. False. That's completely false. We are the new black paradigm. We are the only black paradigm here on 2RAW4TV. But this is the propaganda that these new slave madams have put out, and it's a certain fraternity or sorority, or I should say, of women, of pink women that do this, and you know, so that's out there. There's so many different dynamics because this is an infinite world, so there's so many different things happening right now. What do you guys think? Call in 516-453-9174. We're going in on this subject. I do want to get to all the callers. We're officially in the archives. So if you're online right now, you know what I'm saying, you have made it, go ahead and subscribe to the channel. I do want to get to all the callers that are online right now. 661, you're online with 2RAW4TV. Interracial relationships are mind control. What's your thoughts on that?
I believe they are, especially with the white female and the black male, because a lot of times the black male is just, I mean, the white female is just trying to drain their energy like the Kardashians. And mm-hmm. I'm not against the Puerto Rican, the Mexican, the Indian, the so-called Puerto Rican Mexicans, because we are all one if we know our history. So I don't oppose to that. I'm with that, but I'm against the European and the so-called black person as a relationship.
I feel you. Where are you calling from?
I'm calling from California.
All right, Cali, that's what it is. We had to understand what's happening, absolutely. And I hear what you're saying 100%. We have to understand what's happening and, you know, realize that it's for the most part, interracial relationships has been a war tactic pink people have been using against black people. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So we have to recognize what's happening.
For one thing, we're in a spiritual war, and with the music industry, they only want the black person for their melanin and organs, sell their souls so they can kill them and get all their body parts, and our youth is falling for it left and right just for a dollar.
Yeah, absolutely.
But I will not lay up with the Caucasian man after all my ancestors have been through. I would dare not disrespect them like that.
Absolutely. And there's a lot of people in a lot of program places. There's places that are under complete mind control, that, you know, whole counties and stuff like that that have been, you know, their ancestors may have been the founders of the town, but their ancestors, but like, you know, in the 1900s, and they were killed, and they were replaced, and people were beaten and dismissed. So we have a lot of hidden history that programs these towns and places and states that, you know, a lot of people are under direct mind control, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, but at the same time, we have to understand, you know, all the dynamic of what's happening right now. Black people are coming into power, whether you like it or not. Pink Power Rangers are no more. All of that prancing around with privilege is ending tonight. And we're waking up. We have woke up. We have woken up. So, you know, we have woken up. So we have to understand what's happening right now is
we're in a spiritual war and what everything is in divine order, but we're in a spiritual war at the same time.
Oh, yeah, we're in a spiritual war. We're in a physical war. It's definitely, I mean, a brother just got shot in the back, only 17 years old, just today, or yesterday, I'm sorry. But, you know, it's definitely different battlefields that are being embarked on. But at the same time, we had to understand the interracial relationship that we have with this land of mayonnaise has got to change, you know, as a whole, you know what I'm saying? And the warfare itself from the subjugation of the rat race, of the wheel, the hamster wheel, the, you know, that we're constantly in. We had to divorce ourselves from the hamster wheel first. But what do you guys think? Call in. Well, you can't call in right now. We're in the archives. But let me play this. Someone had mentioned. Dr. Umar's take on it, and I do want to play that. I want you guys to mark your calendars for the 28th of this month. Dr. Claude Anderson is going to be on 2RAW4TV. It's going to be an amazing discussion, 101 questions you never thought to ask. But let's hear Dr. Umar's take on interracial relationships.
Let me speak to that. Right now, we have a global situation where a lot of Africans, men and women, are dating outside of their race because they believe we live in a post-racial society. Understand the four stages of white supremacy. First, white supremacy establishes itself. White supremacy then maintains itself. White supremacy then expands itself. And then white supremacy refines itself. We are in the stage of refinement. Refinement means that white supremacy has perfected the art of not looking like white supremacy. For example, you see a lot of African men marrying outside of their race all across the world, but they fail to recognize that the woman they're marrying, who's normally a white woman, belongs to the global white supremacist order. So although he's the husband and she's the wife, she still has the power. At any point in that relationship, she could pick up a telephone, accuse him of a particular crime, and regardless of whether he committed it or not, his whole life would be changed. Furthermore, we have to recognize that women live longer than men. So if I, as an African man, marry a European woman, or a Chinese woman, or an East Indian woman, or an Arab woman, whatever wealth I accumulated in my life, when I die, my wealth goes over to the woman of that race. We need that money to build the institutions and industries. So how does a black man with full consciousness, who claims to be loyal to his mother and loyal to his people, marry a woman who is not in the image of his mother, whom he knows after he dies is going to take his resources and give them to her race, not his? Marrying outside of your race for an African man anywhere on earth is one of the greatest acts of racial betrayal, treason, and treachery. It is absolutely, absolutely intolerable and disrespectful to black women. With so few black women finding husbands, how do you find it within your soul to marry somebody else's daughter who you know is only eloping with you because you have education, income, economics, privilege, position, or property. These women are not marrying poor black men. They're marrying well-educated black men on purpose. It has nothing to do with love. If it was about love, why can't we find rich East Indian women, rich Chinese women, rich white women marrying poor black men? Why is it always well-educated and stable black men marrying poor white women, Chinese women, or East Indian women? In Africa right now, we have a situation in Nigeria where African women are marrying Chinese men. Chinese men are exploiting these women's desire to marry outside of their race and hopefully improve their economic stability. So sisters are reaching out for the Chinese men because they're poor. And when they see the Chinese face, they assume that all of them are wealthy, which is not true. In fact, most of the Chinese coming into Africa are coming there poor, but they become rich off of us. And so what's going to happen is history is going to repeat itself. These Chinese men are going to have babies with our African sisters, and those babies will be 100% citizens of the nation of Nigeria and other nations where this is taking place, because Nigeria is not the only one. So the children, the biracial Chinese African children, will be 100% citizens of Nigeria, but they will be raised by their Chinese fathers to be loyal to the mother country of China. So these African Chinese will be African in body, but Chinese in mind. And they're going to use the next generation of African Chinese interracial babies to reconquer the entire West Africa because of our hatred for ourselves. This has happened before. The East Indians did it in South Africa. The Arabs did it in East Africa. This has happened before. The white man did it all throughout Africa, mixing with our children and using the babies, the biracial offspring, the psychologically confused offspring, to work in the interest of the country that rules. And so they're going to use those children to serve China, serve India, serve Europe. They look black, but their minds will be psychologically engineered by that other non-African parent to work against the best interests of our mother country. I am totally 100%, as the Honorable Marcus Messiah Garvey said, we are against interracial dating. The only marriage I respect is a black man with a black woman. I do not respect a black man with a white woman, a black woman with a white man, or any other race, including a black woman with a black woman or a black man with a black man. I don't do that nonsense either. The only African marriage is the traditional African marriage, and that's a black man with an African woman.
Fantastic.
Hello?
I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Dr. Claude Anderson is going to be on the next 2RAW4TV. And set your calendars, set your alarm clocks, put it on your game console, because this is going to change the course of black progression and black history. So you guys put it on your calendar. Dr. Claude Anderson, 101 questions you never thought to ask.
We're supposed to be controlling like black hair. We're the only people got a certain texture of hair, thickness of hair. If it calls curly or kinky, what you want to call it? Why is it the Koreans are controlling black? Why is it the Koreans are controlling black hair care? That 85 cents out of every dollar goes to Asians, the Koreans. Why are Koreans and Chinese controlling black hair care and black hair care products? Because you're not practicing good economics. If I go to a Chinese place and I ask them to buy something from black folks, they won't do it. Some black distributors came right here to Washington, D.C., to H Street right over here, and said, we'd like to meet with some merchants, sell you some products. And the agent said, what do you want to sell? He said, we'll sell you some of the same products you got on your shelf right now. We'll sell it to you and give you a 25 to 30% discount. The agent said, we're not interested. The agent said, but with a 25 to 30% discount, you're still not interested? They said, no. They said, why not? Agents say, you black won't understand. It ain't the money. It's that we only buy from our own people. You blacks are the only people that buy from any and everybody.
Hey, so you buy what I'm saying? It ain't the money. That we only buy from our own people. You blacks don't think we're buying from everybody.
Mexican people on the border are having an uncomfortable interracial relationship with America right now. On the border of Mexico and other places where there is a Walmart, maybe even near you. The conspiracy theory, which is no conspiracy theory anymore, is that Walmart were fronts for government-issued concentration camps. No longer is it just clickbait. No longer is it just rumor or hashtags. It's concrete. It's real. And a lot of people are being separated from their parents and things of that nature. But this is America. You know, this is what they do. This is the only way this structure could survive is by horrendous acts like that. Now, we all know that they still separate black people from their children. At the same time, we had to put it out there that, you know, you have to adopt black. You had to be black and be bold. You know what I'm saying? There's black Mexicans that are suffering too. You know, my grandfather was a black Mexican, and we got to recognize that we are the children of the sun. So if you're Mexican, you know, by any means necessary, you know, do it, like claim your children. You know what I'm saying? If you have to do you have to call on the ancestors. Call on the ancestors. The ancestors are here, you know, and we have to understand what's happening, because it's happening all around the country. It could happen at a Walmart near you. And they're learning hard what black people already know. And unless they claim what is their children, you know, they don't claim the land. They let you say, this is Mexico, this is America. You know, they fought you over it. They did all these different things. A lot of people that call themselves Mexican, especially ones with Germanic heritage, you know, because there's a lot of Mexicans, the ruling class of Mexicans are actually of German nature that was brought there in 2000 and after World War II, and, you know, actually violently replaced the leadership there in Mexico. So, you know, do you have a lot of fake Mexicans? Like, you have a lot of fake Indians? You have all these people hiding under all of these different terms and definitions that they put out there. And they put out the definition of freedom, and you still don't have it. They call you free, and you celebrate Juneteenth on the weekend of Juneteenth, but have to go to work on the actual day. So what do you guys think? Call in. Well, you can't call anymore. I keep on saying that, but I noticed the archives. We're going in tonight. Interracial relationships are mind control. And let me do this. I do want to play this last clip real quick. Hold on for a second, y'all. Now, I need y'all to be in Atlanta on the 30th of this month, the last Saturday of this month. P.P. Newton Gun Club is having a meet and greet with refreshments, with real revolutionaries at 695 Metropolitan Parkway in Atlanta, Georgia. I don't care where you are, you need to be there on the 30th. So, let me play this clip. And salute to everybody that's rocking with me. that's seen everything that's going down. Salute to all the listeners that are online right now, the thousands and thousands of people that have listened to 2RAW4TV over our 7 years. I want to play this. This is when you invite racism in your home. You know, this is an actual incident that happened of a swirling couple, the white person going off racially. You'll just hear what is happening.
You don't fucking hate me.
I'm fucking listening to you.
You called me the N-word?
Don't leave.
And you called me the N-word?
Don't leave.
And...
You gotta do a first.
But you hit women, though. But you hit women, though.
And
you get your ass beat.
You. I never hit any woman but you.
Okay,
you
sure.
Fucking treat me like...
You're gonna hit me. For no reason.
I wanna go home.
No, my fucking ugly. Lord.
These people don't have the same sort of. See, we always try to put ourselves in other people's shoes, and because someone has, you know, they're able to stand upright, speak right, they may not have anything that makes them a civil person on the inside. They're sentient beings, but they may not have. They don't have the same sort of feelings that you do. They used your baby gator bait. They lynched you and called it a picnic. Pick a nigger.
Mm-hmm.
They did all these things to you, and then all of a sudden, when you wake up, they're at your workplace. They create this workplace. You know what I'm saying? This unnecessary competition that they have with each other, and they put everybody in there, and there's pink people that are right there, and they're at the water cooler with you and talking, and it's a false reality. These same people are the benefactors of slavery. These parasitical pink people have done so much death and destruction to the land that they call America. I call it a land of mayonnaise. And we are still coming from a pure place for the most part. You know, we love. We are loving people for the most part. You know, we don't want to see harm done to people. We want to actually love people, and that's how we went around the world, and that's how we were able to amalgamate in different cultures around the world, black people and different types of black people around the world. Well, we had to understand that we had to let go of the American dream. We had to let go of all these hindrances in our own mind. You know what I'm saying? And if you're on the line, you have let go of a lot of those hindrances just off the top because you're here with me. So you are part of the revolution. You have let go a lot of that stuff mentally, but it only takes one person. It only takes one person, one powerful individual to change the world. Don't let them tell you anything else. Let me do this, but I do want to play this clip too. And this is with a couple, you know, one of the, because they don't have the same feelings towards their, you know, a lot of people that are pink. And we're going to get it, I want to have a discussion later on, not on this broadcast, but you know, a lot of people have a complexion and they're told to be this. Like the Irish were not considered white until the 1920s, you know, and we had to understand that there's a lot of different dynamics, but what matters is the work you put in. What are you willing to do for the black nation? So that's what matters the most. And let me play this clip right now.
Welcome to Wake Up the Black Nation, Richmond X, your urban war correspondent, signing on. And on today's show, I'm going to be discussing another incident of when swirling goes bad. Michigan man reportedly runs girlfriend over with his car, killing her, then tries to cover it up. And this article is about a white man who ran over his black girlfriend, and then he tried to cover it up. So many black women out here who I have met, they are in search of a white daddy. They are in search of a white savior because they think that this white man is going to save them and treat them well, like their princess. And then they get with these white men, only to be subjected to terror, only to be subjected to physical and verbal abuse, not knowing, not understanding that the European man is the biggest murderer on earth, the biggest killer in the face of human history. Do you realize how many white men killed other white men during World War I and World War II? These men go all over the planet destroying, killing, pillaging. You see? So don't think you get because you're getting with this white man. Serena Williams got a lot of y'all moms messed up. Tyra Banks, Eve, Meghan, Markle, the half black, half European woman, got a lot of y'all minds messed up. I don't think you can fathom evil these men are. And so let's read this article. A Michigan woman's family is struggling to cope after authorities say her boyfriend ran her over with his car on June 2nd, killing her. Brandon Scott Merrow, 28, was arrested on first-degree murder charges last week after Davidson Township police found his girlfriend, Taisha Kemp, lying unconscious in the road, station WNEM reported. Emergency responders said that the 26-year-old did not have a pulse and wasn't breathing. She was pronounced dead at the scene. Police determined Kemp had been struck by a car and quickly zeroed in on Meadows as a suspect in her death. She flipped up in the air, hit the windshield, rolled around, and then hit the back window, breaking that before she went to the ground, Genesee County Prosecutor David Leighton said in a statement. There's a lot of physical evidence of her contacting his car right where the damage is to his car and on the areas where there's damage. We found her clothes, bits of her hair, and she had a bad shoulder laceration that matches up directly with a piece of the car. So there's pretty compelling evidence that he killed this sister. And I'm looking at his face, and it's just a foul-looking devil. I don't understand why this beautiful black woman was with this beast. Melrose was arranged Tuesday, June 5th, on charges of premeditated murder, witness intimidation, failure to stop at the scene of an accident, and tampering with evidence. The murder charge alone could place Merrow behind bars for life without parole, while the other charges carry 10 to 15 year sentences. After his crime, Leighton said Merrow returned to the scene with Kemp's mother. He went back to the scene with his sister's mother later that morning in an effort to cover his tracks. In action, the prosecutor said, usually happens in cases of arson. Mm-hmm. The victim's family said they're still struggling to make sense of it all. They said that we are trying to be strong for each other, get her laid to rest, and then deal with our emotions. Erica Bunn, Kim's adopted sister, told WNEM. And y'all can read the rest of this article on AtlantaBlackStar.com. This is very unfortunate. Black women, understand that the white man has never been your man. He was not created for you. You must stay away from him. He is the evilest, most vicious man on the face of the planet. And unfortunately, this sister got caught up and killed by this beast. This is very unfortunate. But there's another sister who I did a story about earlier this year. Very similar situation. Got into a relationship with these pale males,
and the pell-mell ended up choking her to death. You understand me? And leaving her on the side of the road like a piece of trash. This is what they think about you, black woman. He is not the man for you. The only man for you is the black man. And so overstand, swirling will always go bad in the end. It will always go bad. And I'm looking at the picture of this sister, and she was such a beautiful woman. He did not deserve to be with her. But unfortunately, she got caught up in Babylon. She got caught in the filth of her. Like Samson did Delilah. And this ended up costing her her life. So you have been warned, brothers and sisters. These movies are trying to tell you, get out. Get out. That should have taught you. Kanye West running around acting all crazy. He done lost his mind due to these Europeans. That should be a warning to get out. Stay with your own nation. You understand me? These people invite you to nothing but filth and murder. You understand? That's the reality. And so I want everybody out there to follow me on Twitter and Instagram, RichmondX300. My new book is out, Black Nationalism in the 21st Century. If you would like to purchase it, email me, wakeuptheblacknationradio@yahoo.com. And always remember, swirling will always go bad in the end. Salute.
Interracial relationships are mind control. We're talking about that. Let me do this. We learned what the Queen of Spades are, and let me do that. Let me matter of fact, I'm gonna go and read a description so people that have just called in at the last minute. I saw you guys. I'll read the description of the Queen of Spades or this write up. Among young, mostly white females, there is a growing subculture known as Queen of Spades. It typically involves women getting a permanent or temporary tattoo on their body of a Queen of Spades symbol with the letter Q on it. It usually is kept hidden, but when exposed, it basically means that those women are looking for sex exclusively with black men at that moment. At a deeper level, there's a philosophy behind this subculture that makes the women see themselves as property of black men. So it goes beyond just expressing a preference into self-objectification. But we know that's false. This is a group that's been around since pink people have been here. And it's a secret society, basically white women that are either in marriages or committed relationships with white men. So they go and go black hunting. They go black hunting, and but the very name has a lot of racist overtones. The Queen of Spades, she's calling you a spade. She's calling you a nigger in your face with the Queen of Spades tattoo and the Queen of Spades, and then you're like, but black people don't know. But if you're on this line, you know. And I want you guys to definitely know that they are interracial relationships are mind control. We need to get out of all mind control in ourselves and know that we are supreme beings. Know that we have the power to change our conditions and make them completely different. And have a different world for ourselves and each other. And it's happening now. It's happening right here on 2RAW4TV. Everybody that is listening knows what's going on. It's aboard, and, you know, and it's changing. A lot of people here are actively changing their conditions. So we have to understand that it has been used for a tactic of war. It has been used for mind manipulation, and we need to get out of that. You know, we need to get out of manipulation, period. And interracial relationships are mind control. So that's what I had to say about that. You guys call, make sure to mark your calendars, Dr. Claude Anderson, being with 2RAW4TV on the 30th of this month. Not the 30th, but the 28th, next Thursday. So you guys definitely want to be part of that. So go ahead and start following the show and stuff like that. Sorry, I'm trying to do so many different things at one time. It's live, it's raw, and you know. But we're going in, and this has been one of the most radical conversations that of 2018. You're not going to hear it anywhere else. You're only going to hear it on 2RAW4TV, CNN, Fox News, all these other guys. They're not going to tell you the truth. You could only see the truth. Like, they're going to give you distractions. They're going to constantly give you distractions. They're going to constantly keep telling you these different lies. And we have to be extremely aware and extremely awake. It's not just a thing about, you know, being awake, but you're in the bed still. You got to get up. You got to get active. You got to get moving. You know what I'm saying? But you guys come to Atlanta on the 30th of this month. That's the last Saturday. We're having the Huey P. Newton Gun Club of Atlanta meet and greet. There's going to be refreshments. There's going to be a lot of great movements happening right now, right at that time. So you're going to want to be a part of that. And I want to play this track from Live It Up Ant. Big time salute to everybody that's online listening right now. You know, I want to definitely give a shout out to everybody that's listening, everybody that's called in. It's worldwide. So spread the word, awaken others, and win the revolution within. It's 2RAW4TV.
You got the man up to handle these situations. This white man that you think is such a threat, who's so powerful. You understand? They're laughing at you.
In the trap, yeah.
You're supposed to be the biggest, baddest thing on this corner of the galaxy, nigga. Right. Where's your motherfucker? Where's your fight at? Huh? What are you doing? Black man, what are you doing?
My job is done. My job is done. Just to get closer to you, I had to run. No tiptoeing, no skipping neither, cause that ain't fun. You know the motive, we gon' live and die by the gun. Young artist, man, my heart is beating harder than these drums. I know what is coming, I'm getting ready for when it comes. My spirit is aligned, I could not be told differently. Searching you will find, but this shit has been sent to me. The message from the universe, I feel this is the eclipse. That's why I kiss my woman, and I walk around with three clips. This is not no violent shit, no this is for protection. I am that lieutenant, I'm searching for perfection. But that shit can only come when we drop revolution. I hope I ain't the only one who came to this conclusion. My OG had to sit me down and show me what's at stake. So from now on I'll stay solid, no I will not break. This might be my last day. If tomorrow comes and I ain't here, just know I had to borrow the sun. It ain't no secret no more, I will be back. Just know you can call on me, Lieutenant Black. Yeah. My job is done, my day is finished. Lost so much electrolytes, gotta replenish. I just take them evil spirits and then I diminish. Please don't worry, baby, I'll be back at 9 or maybe 10-ish. I walk through chipped and gold, looking like a pharaoh. My opposition's old, looking like a scarecrow. No need to show my fangs, no need to tell them who I am, cause they gon' know my name. Every time they hear me, I go him. I probably should drop you some knowledge and then leave you polished. Cause half of these prophets only drop it when they get deposits. Hope if I leave this world, you will see all my efforts. We created this earth, ocean, rivers, and deserts, even them pyramids. I'm cooking information in this pot and then I lift the lid. See all that steam? Yeah, that shit hot. Ain't no time to cruise, it's time for me and you to bust a move. My tires blew, but I got spares, so it's time to groove. Yeah, we marching. Yeah, we marching. We ain't got no time to lose. Ain't no options. Yeah, we got it. Yeah, we got it. You can try and take me down, but watch I reincarnate. We don't die, we just come back even stronger. Just wait. Tomorrow comes, and I ain't here. Just know I had to borrow the sun. It ain't no secret no more. I will be back. Just know you can call on me, Lieutenant Black.